Welcome to this lecture. So in this lecture, we will learn about the built-up column. We will see how we can design the built-up column. And this is the content that we are going to discuss in this lecture. So first we will see what is built-up column and what are the various types of built-up column. And in this lecture, we will be mainly focused on built-up box column. And then we will take an example to understand this problem. So talking about the built-up column, well, built-up sections can be in the form of built-up beam or built-up column. Well, built-up sections are those sections which are composed of two or more sections of the same material. So here we have the built-up column. So therefore, built-up columns are those columns which are composed of two or more sections of the same timber. So here you can see some of the example of timber built-up column. Here in the first diagram, you can see there are basically seven planks. So this column is composed of seven planks. And similarly, then in this case also, there are six planks for the column. And this column is composed of four planks. So basically, this built-up column is mainly composed of two or more sections. So that is known as built-up column. And if the material is timber, then it becomes timber built-up column. So now we have different types of built-up column that are generally used in the timber structures. So in that, one of the very important column known as layered column. So in this case, a layered column is basically composed of the planks. So here you can see the same column I have shown you in the previous slide. So here you can see this layered column is composed of three planks of more or less similar thickness. So they are clamped or glued together. Clamping can be done with the help of bolting, or they can be glued. So these columns are known as the layered column. Then we have the next type of column, which is called the spaced column. Spaced column is also similar to the layered column, but if we compare between them, layered column is basically a solid column. There is no gap in the cross section, but in the spaced column, we use the planks, but in between the planks, there is a gap. So here you can see there is one plank is on the right side and one plank on the left hand side. And there is a space maintained along the length of the column. So if we consider this as the length, so they are clamped such that there is a space along the length. So these columns are used when light load is coming on the column. So just to save the material, so we can provide this space. So the column so formed is known as spaced column. So this spacing can be maintained by providing some spacing block or generally or the end blocks. So if we are providing providing blocks on the ends, then they becomes end blocks. Or if we are providing blocks in between the end blocks, then they are known as the spacer blocks. And then another timber built-up column known as box column. So this box column is, we will be mainly focusing on this box column. Now, box column is a specific type of built-up column. In this, four components of the member are generally placed on the periphery of the column cross-section. And the core can be hollow or solid. In the cross-sectional diagram, I will be showing. So these are the three types of box column. In this type, you can see the internal part is solid, or this we can call it as core. So this core is solid. Some material is provided in this, and planks are provided on the periphery. So you can see the arrangement of the planks in this. Similarly, in this diagram, you can see the core is hollow. This is hollow core. And the members are placed on only on the periphery of the this hollow this core basically, and these members are such, I mean they are so arranged that the overall cross section of the column becomes square. So they are generally arranged in this manner. Similarly, in the first case you can see in the core some planks are provided, so that can also be considered as a box column. But generally the second one and the third one are the common example of the box column. So as I said, members are usually arranged in the form of square cross section. And basically, why do we provide these sections on the periphery? This is basically to derive their high efficiency. We know that we have discussed in the previous lecture also that the slenderness ratio is very important in the column design. And if the slenderness ratio is high, the chances of buckling or bending of the column is high. Similarly, if the lambda value is low, the chances of bending or buckling of the column is low. So we know that lambda is basically the S by D. This is the relation, and S is the length of column and D is the least lateral dimension. So to get the value of lambda low, what we can do is we can increase the value of D. And now what is D? D is the least lateral dimension. So least lateral dimension is again related to the cross-sectional dimension. So here we have this D. So if we provide these planks on the periphery, the value of D will be higher, and subsequently the value of lambda will be lower. So therefore, there will be high efficiency of the material which we are using in this case. So that is why we provide these members on the periphery of the core. So as I said, we will be mainly focused on designing a box column in this lecture. So we will see more details about the box column. So here first we will talk about the classification. So as we have discussed in the previous lectures also, column in this case also can be classified as short column, intermediate column, or the long column. And this classification is based on the slenderness ratio. Now, if we talk about the short column, what is the criteria for slenderness ratio in this case? So for short column, slenderness ratio in this case can be calculated by this relation. In the solid column, we used to have this formula for the lambda, but in the box column, this formula is modified in this form, S by root D1 square plus D2 square. Now, what is D1 and D2? That we will see in the diagram. So here, if we consider the hollow box column, so in this case you can see basically we have two square. One is the outer square with the side D1, and the second one is the internal square with side D2. So if we have the value D1, if we have the value D2, we can find out the lambda value for this case. Now if this lambda value is less than 8, then we classify the column as short column. And for this, the permissible compressive stress will be equivalent to Q into FCP. We know that this FC is the permissible compressive stress for short column, and FCP is the permissible compressive stress which we can find out from the permissible stress table. And it is multiplied with this parameter, which is Q. This Q is actually dependent on the thickness, and for all thickness of the plank, this Q value is actually 1. So ultimately we can say that FC is is equals to FCP in case of short column. Then we have the second type of column, which is the intermediate column. Now intermediate column, for the intermediate column, we have slenderness ratio. Again, we can calculate with the same formula. And if the value of lambda is greater than 8, greater than or equals to 8, but less than the value of K9, then we can classify our column as intermediate column. Now, for more clarification, we need to understand how we are going to calculate this K9 value. So like we have calculated K8 value in the previous lecture for the solid timber column, we have here K9 parameter, and we can calculate this K9 parameter by using this relation. So all the relation that I am showing you, they are as per the IS 883, which is the code of practice for timber structures. So as per this IS code, the K9 value can be calculated by this relation. And in this relation, we have some new parameters, like we have U parameter, we have Q parameter. E is the Young's modulus of elasticity of the timber material. And FCP is the permissible compressive stress we get from the permissible stress table. So here we need to understand how we calculate this U value. This U value is actually a constant which depends on the thickness of the plank. So as you can see, these are the plank and this thickness. This thickness can be termed as T. So this value of U is dependent on the thickness value. And we have a small table to get the value of U. So you can see here, well, the maximum thickness of plank can be 50 mm. And for if the thickness of plank is 25 mm, then the value of U is 0.8. Similarly, if the thickness is 50, the value of U is 0.60. Now, in case if the plank thickness is between 25 and 50, say if the thickness is 35 mm. So in that case, we have to find out U value by interpolation method. We generally find out with this interpolation method. So we will discuss about this interpolation method in detail when we will be solving the problem. Now here you can see the value of Q is also dependent on the thickness, but for all the thickness, this value is 1. So whether our thickness is 20 mm, 25 mm or 40 mm, the value of Q is same, which is 1. So from this relation, we can find out U value with this table and Q value again with this table. And the value of E and FCP can be found from the permissible stress table. And once we get all the value, we can calculate the value of K9 to get the column, whether it is intermediate column or long column. So now here also, we have to ensure that the width of plank, as you can see, width of plank is something like this. This is the width of plank. Say this is B, and if this is the thickness, so it says we have to ensure that width of plank should not be greater than 5 times the thickness of plank. So it means the value of B can be less than or equals to 5 times of T only. So we have to maintain this standard, which is recommended by the IS code. Now, once we identify our column as intermediate column, then what is the value of FC for intermediate column? So that we can find out with the relation given by the IS code. So this is the relation to find out the value of FC for intermediate column. FC is the permissible compressive stress for intermediate column. And in this, we have Q value, FCP, K9, which we have just calculated using the relation. And D1, D2, all these things we know already. So with this relation, we can find out the value of FC. Now, the next category of the column is long column. Now, we know that long column will be classified when the value of lambda, when the value of lambda is greater than, sorry, this will be K9. When the value of lambda is greater than K9. Then we classify our column as the long column. And for long column, the permissible compressive stress, which is FC, can be given by this relation. In this relation, we know U can be calculated by using the table. Lambda is the slenderness ratio and E is the Young's modulus of elasticity and 0.329 is the constant. So with this relation, we can find out the FC value. So that is a theoretical aspect of the box column, built-up box column design. In the next part, we will take an example to understand how we design the built-up box column. Thank you.